Before we start the meeting, I'd like to ask everyone to stand and we'll salute the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. To either of the constables in the town of Brookfield and the county of Worcester, greetings. In the name of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, you are hereby directed to notify and warn the inhabitants of said town qualified to vote in elections and in town affairs to meet at the elementary school, 37 Central Street, Brookfield, Mass, on Friday, the 10th day of June, in the year 2016, at 7 p.m., then and there to act on the following articles. And there's a lot of them. And you are directed to serve this warrant by posting up attested copies thereof at the town hall and post office in said town 7 days at least before the time of the holding of said meeting. Hereof fail not, make due return of this warrant with your doings thereon to the town clerk at the time and place of the meeting given under our hands this first day of June in the year 2016. Selectmen have all signed it. A true copy attests. The constable has signed it. Town clerk has signed it. So everything is in order. And the warrant has been properly served, so we can take care of that. We certainly have a quorum, so the meeting will come to order. Do we have any people in here that are not registered voters in Brookfield? Okay. All right. We're all set with that. When you wish to speak tonight, would you line up at the microphone? The first time that you do speak, would you please state your name? And all comments should be addressed to the moderator, and then I will get you the information that you're looking for. Back is okay. A couple of things I want to explain. Sometimes debate seems to carry on for a while, and so people often think we've gone far enough and they'll move the question. So if anybody makes a motion to move the question, which is to end debate, and there are still people standing at the microphone, those people will be allowed to speak. But once those people have finished, then whoever made the motion gets to make the choice. Do they want to make the motion to end it, or for some reason do they want to let it go on? People, at that point, you can come up, but I'll keep track of who was standing there, and it's clearly whoever made the first initial call, it'll be his or her choice as to whether to move to end a debate, okay? And that takes a two-thirds vote when we get there. Anything else? I can't think of anything else, so we're ready to roll. I have lots of booklets here tonight to look at, so lots of papers.
Someone's phone is vibrating.
Okay. All right, we're good.
That's me?
Yeah.
Whoa. Okay. Article 1. To see if the town will vote to accept the annual report of town officials as printed or take any action relative thereto.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I move to allow the treasurer, police chief, town council, and elementary principal to speak at this evening's meeting.
Okay, motion is made and seconded for something else. The reason he's making that motion is town bylaws require permission be granted to people that are not residents of Brookfield to speak. So that's why he's doing that now. Okay, all in favor of his motion, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Okay, so those people will be allowed to speak later if needed. Okay, back to Article 1.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I move that the town approve the annual report of the town officials as printed.
Okay, motion made and seconded. Any discussion on this one? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, say no. Okay, so Article 1 is taken care of. Article 2, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate such sums of money as may be necessary to defray the expenses of the town for the ensuing year or take any action relative thereto.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I move that the town raise and appropriate such sums of money as may be necessary to defray the expenses of the town for the ensuing year as shown in the fiscal 17 budget advisory committee recommendations as contained in the annotated warrant.
All right, if you would turn to the second half of your yellow booklet. For the past couple of years, I've said I'm reading from a different sheet because I take an electronic sheet and I enlarge it a little so I can see it better. I don't have to say that this year. We're ready to go. Okay, the other thing is I've been informed that a number of items are going to be questioned. So the procedure is I will read the description and the advisory committee recommendation. If someone wants to discuss that, please say question. That's all we really need. And we will go through this entire list. When we finish the list, all those items that were not questioned, we'll take a vote on those and get those done. And then we'll go back and work our way through all the items that have been questioned. Okay? So before we get going on that, do the selectmen or the advisory board want to make any comments about financial numbers before we start? Because it may clarify or it may not, I don't know, but go ahead.
On behalf of the advisory board, we worked very, very hard on this budget this year. Not that we don't on the other years, but we did a lot of research, we got a lot of data. We did the best we could. We're trying to keep the budget in check. As you know, we're teetering on $20 a thousand in our town on our real estate tax. So we really analyzed, and it's up to you people to vote it in or not vote it in. Also, I'd like to say something. We have 300 and, well, it was 322 to start. We're down now, but that 322 is not free cash. A lot of people call it free cash. That's our tax dollars. It's tax dollars left over from budgets. It's from snowstorms. A lot of it came back in from the money that was taken from our town. That's our tax dollars. So don't just think it's money that floated into our town. That's real tax dollars. So when we say free cash, it's not free cash. So when we vote on this stuff, we want to really analyze it, and we worked real hard on the articles as well. So, and thank you all for coming. Thank you.
Selectman, want to make any comments? Okay. All right, let's start. Moderator salary, $50. Selectman salary, $6,000. Selectman administrative wages, $40,922. Clerks, wages, $10,590. Selectmen's expenses, $9,000. Physical exams, $800. Payment in lieu of taxes, $750. Computer maintenance, $3,000. Town website, $9,000.
Question.
Computer security, $2,000. Consultant, grant writer, $10,000. Computer acquisition, $5,000. Reserve fund, $25,000. Town accountant salary, $35,000.
Question.
Town accountant clerk, $10,140. Town accountant expenses, $6,000. Town accountant audit, $0.
Question.
Good. Town accountant audit?
Yes.
Advisory committee expenses, $500. Clerk salary, $500.
Question.
Warrant booklets, $1,200. Assessor's salary, $17,481. Consulting services, $7,000. Expenses, $6,250. Assessor's wages, $31,932.
Question.
Treasurer's salary, $31,862.
Question.
Treasurer clerk, $13,956.
Question.
Payroll services, $5,200. Expenses, $7,990. Collector salary, $41,058.
Question.
Collector's expenses, $9,400. Collector software, $6,860.
Question.
For collector software?
Yes.
Legal services, $55,000. Treasurer, collector tax titles, $10,000. Town clerk salary, $30,833.
Question.
Assistant wages,
$1,680. Question.
Town clerk certification, $0. Expenses, $2,600. Elections and registration wages, $4,805.
Question.
Registration and expenses, $8,226. Conservation Commission clerk wages, $846.
Question.
Expenses, $400. Central Mass Regional Planning Commission, $900.
Hold on just a moment, please.
What was that?
Hold on just 1 second, please. I think I'm caught up. I'm following numbers and you're reading off something else, so we're chasing each other. Okay.
How are you holding?
Planning.
I fell asleep when you went by the assessor's salary.
320. All right. I'm at number line item planning board clerk wages, $3,548.
Question.
Planning board salary, $2,500.
Question.
Planning board expenses, $1,110. Board of Appeals, wages, $805.
Question.
Board of Appeals expenses, $500. Municipal custodian wages, $14,029.
Question.
Municipal property maintenance and improvements, $10,000. Utilities, $5,000. Town Hall improvements, $15,000. Printing Town Report, $1,800. Municipal heating fuel, $30,000. Diesel fuel, $17,000. Gasoline, $21,000. Police wages, full-time, $201,210. Police chief salary, $68,976. Wages, part-time, $54,466. Clerk's wages, $10,979. Overtime wages, $28,000. Expenses, $48,966, and police station expenses, $20,000. Fire department, wages, $21,500. Fire chief salary, $3,545. Fire expenses, $32,750.
Any questions, fire chief? Salary.
Which one?
$885.
Fire chief salary. Okay. Fire recurring recertification testing, $11,000.
Somebody's phone on the table is vibrating.
Who's got a cell phone?
Not him.
I don't have a cell phone, so it's not me. You can rest assured of that. Mine's home right where it should be, turned off. Fire asset repair replacement, $13,000. Telephone contract leases, $11,500. Building inspector salary, $15,804. Assistant wages, $523. Expenses and training, $100. Gas and plumbing inspector salary, $3,913. Assistant wages, $334. Expenses and training, $790. Wiring inspector salary, $3,886.
Question.
Wiring inspector assistant wages, $346.
Question.
Expenses and training, $400. Zoning enforcement officer salary, $7,070.
Question.
Expenses, $380. Emergency management agency salary, $404.
Question.
Expenses, $3,500. Blackboard Connect annual fee, $3,700. Animal control officer salary, $5,700.
Question.
Animal control officer assistant wages, $641. Animal control officer expenses, $2,000. Parking ticket clerk and hearing officer salary, $250.
Question.
Expenses, $100. Tree warden, expenses, $15,000. Shade tree expenses, $2,500. School committee salary, $1,500. Regional committee salary, $1,000. Regional School Assessment, $1,496,113. Transportation, $87,072. School expenses, $2,957,688.
Question.
Highway Superintendent wages, $53,312.
Question.
Operator wages, $79,207.
Question.
Part-time and overtime, $5,146.
Question.
Seasonal worker, $14,560. Administrative assistant, $17,196.
Question.
Police detail and flaggers, $3,500. Expenses, $60,600. Physicals and license renewals, $930. Bridges, rails, and signs, $1,600. Snow and ice account, $75,000. Streetlights, $12,500. Cemetery wages, $17,039.
Question.
Superintendent salary, $4,984.
Question.
Expenses, $6,000. Improvements, $1,500. Board of Health salary, $3,600.
Question.
Board of Health clerk wages, $4,050.
Question.
Board of Health agent, $1,640.
Question.
Animal inspector, $1,121.
Question.
Title V administration, $993. Board of Health expenses, $4,000.
Donald, I think I want to question 1670. You put that in.
1670?
Item, yeah, line item.
I didn't hear it, but we'll do it.
And
Board of Health expenses, $4,000. Community health program, $950. Transfer station wages, $23,855.
Question.
Transfer station well test, $12,064. Transfer station expenses, $86,820. Council on Aging Outreach Worker, $1,500.
Question.
Council on Aging Tri-Valley Crisis Intervention, $799. Medicare, $2,000. Expenses, $400. Director of Veterans Services salary, $1,010.
Question.
Veterans agent salary, $3,535.
Question.
Expenses, $240. Casework, $55,000.
Question.
Library director wages, $39,104.
Question.
Custodian wages, $6,890.
Question.
Assistant wages, $30,143.
Question.
Saturday, holidays, vacation, $3,527.
Question.
Expenses, $13,200. Library books, videos, and periodicals, $23,211. Recreation wages, zero. Commission expenses, $7,700. South Pond Beach expense, $1,250. Historical Commission, $1,185. Memorial Day, $3,200. Cultural Council expenses, $8,650. Debt and interest, regional school, zero. Highway garage principal, $84,530. Interest, $3,973. Town hall roof principal, $30,470. Town hall roof interest, $1,432. Fire truck principal, $21,500. Interest, $1,075. Short-term interest, zero. Police station principal, $59,657. Interest and fees, $15,343. Sawmill dam principal, $7,265. Interest, $3,286. Worcester County retirement, $216,251. Unemployment insurance, $14,000. Group health and life insurance, $441,608. Medicare town share, $47,000. General insurance, $137,000. Water department commissioner salary, $1,800. Water department clerk wages, $10,971.
Question.
Water department superintendent salary, $65,711.
Question.
Secondary operator wages, $2,925.
Question.
Temporary help, $2,525.
Question.
Expenses, $31,170. Okay. That takes care of it.
Mr. Moderator, I just been reminded that right after I fell asleep, I had a senior moment. 3.5, that's the way.
It was questioned already.
Clarence. Did they miss 1190? When you get a little older.
There's a timeout. 3:45?
Yeah.
I already had it circled. So, first, what's that? Okay. All right, before we go any further here.
1190.
320 I have circled, 3:45 I have circled.
On this spreadsheet, it's not.
So, before we go any further, a motion to approve.
Donald?
Paul?
I have a question about why we didn't read 2350. I'd like to include that in the same argument. Line item 2350.
We don't know.
Okay, well let's not go quite there yet. At this point, I would like a motion to approve all the non-questioned items. So we can take care of those, and then I'll just explain how we're going to work our way back to the rest of it. So, would someone like to make a motion to approve all the non-questioned items?
So moved.
And then motion's made and seconded, okay. All those in favor of approving all the non-questioned items,
Mr.
please
Mark.
Say, yeah.
For point of order, on the sheet that was passed out in front, it's itemized at 1190, right, line item 1190, and it wasn't questioned on the floor. I don't know if you want to rescind that or not before you take your vote.
1190.
No, 1190 was in question.
I have 1180 circled. I do not have 1190 circled.
1190 wasn't.
It wasn't questioned.
It wasn't.
Was there a question on it?
It was on my sheet. I marked it.
No, we didn't hear
it. It should have been. How's that sound?
Okay.
All right.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator.
Okay. Are we making a motion to approve the non-questioned items, or do we have something else in mind?
Could you add line 680, please?
But I really don't want to be going back through this all night here. Which one, Peter?
680.
Town hall improvements. Okay. Have we got another one to add? Okay. Are we making a motion to approve? No? Okay. Do we have a basic question? All right, go ahead.
Yes, this is a basic question. First of all, a request from Cable Access, if the select board could please pass the mic back and forth, because there are some individuals that are speaking whom we cannot pick up. My second comment is this layout differs from last year. There are two columns, fiscal year 15 and fiscal year 16. I would like to know if those amounts represent funds expended in that fiscal year or if they represent funds appropriated in that fiscal year. Because normally we show the amounts that each line item has spent in the previous fiscal year as well as what had been voted on. So I'd like to have...
Who wants to try and come up with... Okay.
I won't speak to what's typically there, but what you see before you is what's been voted in the previous year.
Thank you.
So, well, let's try and wend our way back. I'm looking for a motion to approve all the non-questioned items. Thank you, Mr. Cook. Is there a second?
Second.
Good. Okay. Any other discussion on the non-questioned items? All those in favor of approving the non-questioned items, please say aye.
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 All those opposed, no. Okay. Now, we will simply go back to the first one I have a question on. We'll work our way through these and we'll see what transpires. So the first one I have is selectmen administrative wages, and someone take to the floor and we'll get us started.
Since I'm the one that questioned most of them, I'll be the one that will try to explain. The handout front.
In case people don't know you.
Oh, Bruce Clark. Sorry.
Okay.
The handout that was on the table where you signed in reflects a 3% increase in salaries. My proposal is the figures that are in the book get changed to the figures that are on this piece of paper, reflecting a 3% salary increase for all the questioned items under the salary column. There's a couple of them that aren't salaries. They were questions. But this sheet is all salaries. My only question is the bottom one, which was emergency. You didn't read it off. I had it factored in. So it is on my sheet. I don't know whether it's supposed to be there or not.
There's an article later. I don't know what number it is, to be honest with you. But there's an article later to transfer money. And at that point, that would be the place to take care of that one.
Okay, simple an explanation why I believe we deserve and need 3%. At the top, it states our insurance rates went up this year. 1% won't cover the cost of our insurance, the additional cost of our insurance. I also questioned the elementary school's budget. The reason I wanted to question the elementary school's budget, if you took the time to read their contract, year one through year 12, anywhere from 4 to 12% they receive in their contract. This is the support staff, custodial workers, cafeteria workers, secretarial help. I don't think 3% that we're asking for is out of touch. So if there's some way that you could reach deep into your hearts and approve this schedule as printed, the meeting will move a lot faster tonight. Otherwise, I think we're going to visit them item by item. Thank you.
Okay, so for right now, though, we're only doing the selectmen and administrative wages. All the issues, I think, will come out by the time we finish this one. But let's just stay focused on this one item and discussion and keep going. Okay.
Pat Washburn. I guess the reason that I'm questioning the 3% is most people in the world aren't getting, or in the country, aren't getting 3%. I mean, the people that are paying the taxes in this town aren't getting those kind of salary raises. So how can the town employees, who are also, most of them residents of town, justify that they're getting a 3% raise when other people are getting maybe a 1% raise, a 1.2% raise? I mean, with the rate of inflation at this point, we're lucky if we're getting 2%. Most people I know aren't getting that. So I don't see how they justify coming to the town for the second year in a row and asking for another 3% after they asked for 3% last year. And they used the same reasoning last year, and when the advisory board looked into it, the school wasn't getting those kind of salaries. The police department weren't getting those kind of salaries. The regional high school's not getting those kind of salaries. So why do they justify, again for the second year, asking for a 3% raise when most people who are paying the taxes in this town are not receiving that? Thank you.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
For point of clarification, through discussions with a couple of the town employees at selectman meetings, and I'm assuming through advisory committee meetings as well, there was always a reference to the support staff. Through research, the past 3 years, the support staff in 2015 received a 1.5 cost of living increase, 16, 1.34, 17, 2.14. Where our town employees received a 2% pay raise in 2015, a 3% pay raise in 16, and a 3% pay raise in 17. That alone is over 2.5% from that group. This year, the support staff is receiving a 2.25. We have determined through votes, through discussions, that we feel it's fair for 1%. In regards to the group health, you have to also notice that you as a taxpayers are paying almost $500,000 for that portion of employees for group health and life, which is a 6% increase to our taxes.
And I'll refer to the contract at the school. If you care to read it, you will find out they also get a step increase every year. I'm not here to argue the school. Great for them for getting a contract that's that strong. And at the end of their contract, they get 10 cents an hour if they've been here 10 years. They get 19 cents an hour if they've been here 15 years, and 29 cents an hour if they've been here 20 years as a stipend every year in this contract. If you read it, you'd understand it.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I was on the school committee when we established the support staff contract. I was against stepping grades. I'm not going to argue with you there.
Are they there?
Wait a minute. In regards to the stepping grades, both at the teacher level and the support staff level, a majority of those individuals are at the maximum, the ceiling height. My argument is that the town employees are there as well. I believe the maximum is 10 years. The majority of town workers are at that 10-year. The stepping grade is moot in regards to that because of longevity.
It does show 12.
I believe the discussion that I had with the associate superintendent, it was at 10. That's my comparison.
Well, my comparison is if it's good at one end of the street, it should be good at the other end of the street. Plain and simple. I don't think 3% is out of line.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
Back to my original numbers, the equality. The town was over 2.5% from the support staff contract. The equality is there. If anybody should be arguing equality, it should be the support staff, in my opinion.
Herb Chafee, Highway Superintendent. Last year, we did a lot of work in this town and everything else to save the town a lot of money. We helped with the police department and everything else. We saved over $500,000 there, just in site work and everything else. My understanding, what the head janitor is getting here at the elementary school is the same amount of money that I'm getting paid per hour. And all he does is janitor work. And that's support staff. To me, I think that's a slap in the face.
Peter O'Connell. I tend to agree that if we're only comparing percentages, then the proposed 3% raise doesn't look like a strong proposal for the staff. But if you take Herb's argument, we have not had really any effort over the past several years to set out in an equity schedule between the grade level responsibility of a superintendent of the highway or water or anything and an equivalent position elsewhere in town. Generally speaking, the organizations in town that are unionized have received significantly higher pay increases than the non-union staff, and that's been true for a long time. When we have looked at percentage increases, we've looked at the percentage increases for cost of living at the school, but we have not factored in the step increases. So we've had the discussion about, well, the teachers got 1%. Well, they didn't really get 1%. They got 1% or 2% plus their steps. So Mr. Comtois' argument that all of our staff in the town, in the highway and water, the emergency squad and so forth, are maxed out at 10 years, well, they've been basically underpaid for those 10 years. We have balanced the budget of the town on their backs over this longer period of time. We've made some incremental progress, but this is not an unreasonable request for town employees who really have done tremendous service in this past year. So based on that, I'm going to make the motion that line 30 be increased from 40,922 to 41,731.
Second. What line number was that?
30. We're just doing 30, are we not?
Can we get that number again?
$41,731. It's the top number. There is a sheet in the back. I don't know if you got it, Pat.
Yeah, okay. I have it. Thanks.
Okay, any other comments, questions, discussion? Yeah, go ahead.
Just so that you folks are aware, if you ever looked at a traditional step and grade form, which would apply to the town employees in general, it is straight line across how many years you've been here and what grade you're at. If you look at a school formulation for increases by step, and it's by education, it is not straight line. There are chunks of time in there where I believe, correct me please if I'm wrong, that there is no step increase. You only get an increase if you have performed more education, if I'm correct in that way. So to me, you cannot, that it's apples and oranges as far as those two forms go. What it ultimately boils down to in percentages is one thing, but the forms are not the same. Not the form.
But
I'm talking about teachers as well.
Floor.
I'm talking about teachers as well, because in the couple of years that I've been doing this, more often than not, that's what gets brought up, is what the teachers make, not what the support staff make, so.
Mr. Moderator, just
yes.
a point of discussion is that an unfortunate fact is that we have not had the organizational discipline over the last, say, 10 to 12 years to actually follow and then update the wage and step schedule that was supposed to be in use within the town. So to the point of that, yes, there's a step and grade schedule. Yes, we've been doing COLA increases. However, to the best of my knowledge, and no one has actually contradicted me in this, there has not been a pay raise submitted for a single town employee based on the step and grade schedule in over a dozen years. So we need to understand that we've only been using half of the equation as we budget for our wages.
Donald Herbert from the Highway Department. In all the years I've worked for the town, I've never received a raise through the step and grade system. Every year, you go up a year of service, and everything just stays right in the middle of the scale. I could stay another 10 years with the scale the way it is, and that's not going to accomplish me anything financially. So this year, I believe they were trying to update all that, but for one reason or another, it got postponed or whatever for some reason. But that's how the step and grade system works for us guys.
Mary Lou Knight, has anybody done analysis on what the total cost would be to increase wages by 2% or 3%? As opposed to the 1%.
I'll answer it. Yeah, I'll answer that.
Who's got that one? Dave?
Okay, based on the 1%, not counting the police department, not counting the emergency squad or the school, it's about 7,000 to 7,400, somewhere in that range. So you times that by three. If you add everything together, you're probably looking at maybe a 35,000 increase based on a 35%. I mean, a 3% increase. Based on 3% is on a one. Right. Right. But if you add in the police, the school, and the EMS, then it comes up to about 35, somewhere in that range per year.
We got somebody at the mic.
Does that answer your question? Okay.
The sheet I passed out, 3% equals $26,280.
Yeah, but
wait a minute. That's the increase at 3%.
Say that again, please, Mr. Clark.
$26,280. That's the sheet I passed out.
Just so I can make some notes for myself in case you get mixed up later. That is the entire 3%.
Correct.
Okay.
What does that include? What is that including everything?
That includes the sheet I passed out.
Okay, but does that include the police at school?
Wait. Time.
Well, you have to. That's,
this is
okay.
This is going to be one of those testy evenings where your moderator is going to get testy, and the only way we can prevent that is when someone is speaking, you let them finish, then I recognize someone else, and then they speak, and then we continue. So please don't have conversations going back and forth that doesn't really contribute to anything worthwhile. So Mr. Clark was still on the floor, continue, and then we'll let
other people speak. Non-contractual employees were not included in that sheet because they're under contract. And as we read off the items, there might be one or two other people that questioned something that I missed. My intention was not to miss anybody on the wages.
Okay.
Based on what Mr.
Name?
Trudy O'Connell. Based on what Mr. Clark just said, what a 3% raise would cost across the board for the line items that he included for all the wage and salary line items on the handout sheet, it seems that it would be about, let's say about $18,000 more than what is budgeted right now to change it from a 1% to a 3% raise. To me, that doesn't seem like an awful lot of money to show some appreciation for our town employees.
Who are we going? Mr. Honor?
Mr. Honor?
Yep.
I'd like to make a motion to move the question.
Wait, Mrs. Pecor, I recognize.
Okay, and I do happen to agree that it does not sound like a significant amount. I think one of the things that disturbs me every year, if you want to come and ask about percentages in relation to equality with other positions, that's one thing. But to continually bring up things like my health insurance went up, our taxes went up, my, what's it going to be next, my child care went up, we cannot, I mean, everybody takes a hit from what's going on in the economy. So if you want to do it according to percentages, that's fair, that's fine, you have a valid argument, but nobody is out there holding anybody's hand, throwing money at them when they run into hard times. We have to deal with what we have as budgets in our own households, and that's the best we can do. We can ask our employees for raises, and we can argue that we're doing a really good job, and we deserve it, but there hasn't been a raise in the CPI for 2 years. The federal government is not giving any raises to the elderly or to retired military. So, and that's the feds. So, and from what I looked at on the state website, it was about the same on the state website for the CPI as well. So let's just not make it personal. If you want to go according to your percentages, then just keep it that way.
Mr. Confod, you had a while ago.
Make a motion to move the question.
Second. Make a motion to what? Excuse me?
Move the question.
Okay. Mr. Clark was in line there, so we'll let him speak and then we'll come right back.
I just simply have one simple comment. You are our employers, and that's what we are doing, asking you for a raise. Simple as that.
I just don't see somebody.
Okay, whoop.
That's all.
See, Mr. Comptoir had a motion. You want to make it now?
Make it for the third time, Mr. Motter. I'd like to move the question.
Okay, motion is made and seconded to move the question. All those in favor of ending debate on selectmen and administrative wages, please say aye. I'm thinking about this because we haven't, we're ending debate on the 41,731, and then we'll take a vote on that. So all those in favor of ending debate on that, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Okay, so debate is over. So now we're voting on administrative wages, $41,731. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, please say no.
No.
Where are my counters? Let's do this so we, no question about it. All those in favor of line item 30 reading $41,731, please stand.
Thank you.
26.
Okay, all those opposed, would you please stand? It's pretty high tech, Jim.
Yeah.
I'm up.
Three. I got nine.
Okay, the motion is approved. I should have added this up before. 40, 53, 53 to 12. Okay. Next one, municipal clerk wages.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
Based on that vote, to speed things up this evening, I'd like to make a motion to, and I'm going to go over this line by line if you don't mind, make a motion to approve the following line numbers to the numbers reflected in the handout. Will you accept that motion?
Make it and get a second, and then I'll respond to it.
Okay. Line item number 40. Line item. Let's see, 200 wasn't. Was it?
That was a question.
200.
Hold
on. Okay. Yes, sir.
Can I interrupt? Are you making a motion to approve everything on the sheet?
No, because a lot of the some of the questions didn't reflect the 3%.
Right, but this would cover all the lines that did.
If I'm going to make the motion, I'd just like to double check, Mr. Moderator.
Except 2050. There are other items that are not on this list
exactly.
That were questioned that we still need to go even.
That's why.
When we finish with this list, we still have other items we need to go back and work on.
Correct. So again, item number 40. 320. Actually, I'm sorry, I retract 320. 345, 360, 365, 400, 460, 470, 500. 540, 580, 630, 800, 970, 980, 1020, 1030, 1060, 1070. No. 1140, 1180, 1190, 1360. 1370, 1380, with an understanding that 1370 is actually reduced by Mr. Clark's sheet, 1390, 1560, 1570, 1640, 1650, 1660, 1670, 1720, 1800, 1810, 1870, 1880, 1890, 1900, 2260, 2270, 2280, and 2290, as reflected in the sheet submitted.
Okay. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay. Now, time out. I'm going to go through and I'm going to reread the numbers that are in the motion to be approved. If anyone objects to any of the numbers being included that are on this list, say so, and we'll pull those out. Otherwise, we'll proceed to vote on all of these, and then we'll go back and we'll vote on all of the ones that were left out and anything else in the book that we haven't, that's not on this list.
Just an explanation as to how I achieve these numbers?
Where do we take care of this first? I'm going to read the numbers that are on the list. Okay, these are the ones that if we pass this motion, we're going to end up voting on. And I'm going to read them rather quickly.
Donald?
I'm hoping you're on this.
If I could just enlighten the department heads to look at the number and make sure it's correct.
Okay. Here are the numbers. Line items, 40, 345, 360, 365, 400. 460, 470, 500, 540, 580, 630, 800, 970, 980, 1020, 1030, 1060, 1070. Hello?
Too fast.
Okay. 40, 345, 360, 365, 400, 460, 470, 500, 540, 580, 630, 800, 970, 980, 1020, 1030, 1060, 1070, 1140, 1180, 1190, 1360, 1370, 1380, 1390, 1560, 1570, 1640, 1650, 1660, 1670, 1720, 1800, 1810, 1870, 1880, 1890, 1900, 2260, 2270, 2280, 2290. Okay. So, if anybody would like any one of those items pulled from this list, please let me know. Okay. I did not read every number on the list, but so the only ones in a minute that we're going to vote on are the ones that I just read, and then we still have others to go back to. Okay? So, the motion is to approve all of those line items that I just read with the numbers that are printed on this sheet that was at the back of the table when you came in. Any questions on that? Okay.
Doug Ford. We got to specify, are you talking 1% or 3%? That's got to be in the motion or else...
No, we're voting... We're voting on the numbers.
What are we voting on?
These numbers that are on this sheet,
yes,
are the 3% increase.
That's what I wanted to hear. You see, nobody had said 3% before,
okay,
so that's what I wanted to clarify.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, anybody? Whoops, I got to get behind, come out from behind the post there. Okay.
I don't know if this is a question asked right now. Are we allowed to ask a question why one was left off, or are we going to have
I would entertain.
No, we'll come to those separately. If it's left off of this list, we'll still, when we finish the list, we'll bring it up for discussion. So, anything else on this list? No? Okay. All those in favor of approving the checked items, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed say no.
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 Okay. The items that were checked are now also in the approved category. So now you got to give me a minute here to... Boy, I'm earning my money tonight. All right. Okay. The first one that I see that was questioned that has not been discussed yet is town accountant salary.
No.
So.
90. Line number.
Whoops, time out. Oh my goodness.
Doing line by line.
Good thing somebody's keeping me straight. Line item 90 on the first page, town website. Who had a question?
Jennifer Grabowski. If someone could just kind of chat with me a little bit about what's going on with this line.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
Jen and I shall chat. We've been advised that the retention of the emails is not there. Going out to bid for that, it's approximately $7,000 for that, plus additional costs for Mr. George, who's maintaining that.
It's for email, not the website?
Website and email retention.
Okay.
Through the server.
All right, thank you.
Ben? The question is Clement, or?
I was just going to clarify a little further, but we can leave it. If that's adequate, then we'll go with it.
Hi.
Mr. Moderator, I was going to offer a little additional information, but if we're good with it, we'll just go with it.
Thank you.
It's not whether I'm good with it.
You need a motion now?
I will in a second. Okay, somebody needs to move. As we go through all these remaining items, someone, when you first stand up, it would simplify life if you were to make a motion to approve a certain dollar amount, and then we can know what our discussion will be. So if someone...
Mr. Moderator.
Yes.
I'd like to move to accept line item number 90 at the amount of $9,000.
Okay. Any other discussion on that item?
Mr. Tack.
Okay. All in favor of the $9,000 for line item 90, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? No. Okay. That one's done. Okay. Now, town accountant salary. Who wants to speak to this one?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd just like some kind of an explanation. In 15, the salary was $48,469, went up in 16, and it's going down by 15%. I think we're looking at a new... 30%, I'm sorry. I'd like an explanation, and we're looking at a new accountant. I mean, are we talking about cutting wages that much?
Mr. Moderator?
Okay, yep, you're on, Mr. Compton.
With the restructuring of that department, we're actually adding a clerk to that department. You can see that represented in the $10,140, and we are reducing the hours required from that department, which results in the decrease in that line item.
Okay, before we go any further, I need somebody to make a motion for a number for that town accountant salary.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I move to accept line item 200 at the amount of $35,000.
Okay, we had a second, okay? So now we're discussing 35,000 as the number.
Mr. Moderator, I'd just like to know a little bit more about the plan for hiring a town accountant and why we're hiring a clerk instead, and I'm just looking for some more information about what the plan is for that department.
Who wants to try and tackle that one?
I can try to help, Mr. Moderator. Okay. We're reducing the hours to 15, approximately 15 to 20 hours for that department with an addition of a clerk. So if that individual actually goes on vacation or we're short-sighted and actually moves again, we have somebody in place that'll pick up the ball. So for us as a Board of Selectmen, I believe the Advisory Committee as well, believe that it's a win-win.
That doesn't really answer my question. I understand that you're going to hire a clerk, which is great, but can you tell me a little bit more about what the plans are for the town accountant position? And
It is advertised. We've had two applicants that have applied. We have an interim accountant currently. And then once we hire an accountant, and she's doing an excellent job as well.
And so you think the hours for the new town accountant will be enough?
Yes.
If she has a, or he has a clerk for that many hours?
We do.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
How many hours did the old accountant get?
Was it 36?
36.
36 hours?
Yes. And the new proposal would be?
I believe we talked 15 to 20. We'd have to see where we are with
20 hours.
This is 35,000.
And the hours for the clerk?
It's 15, wasn't it? 15.
16?
15.
15. Thank you.
Okay.
Are we doing an audit since our town accountant left?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
Yes, we are.
When should that be completed by?
I don't know the completion. I believe they're starting next month.
And what are we paying the clerk?
I do not know the hourly wage off the top of my head. I don't know if anybody here does.
Mr. Moderator?
Yeah.
The clerk's hourly wage will be $13 an hour. That's what it's calculated off of.
Okay, but we're asking or we're looking for someone to be a clerk who would be working for a municipal accountant, and that would be a special clerk or a special person that would have to know municipal law just as well and would have to be taught municipal law just as well as our town accountant. I don't know about you, but I wouldn't step into that position at $13 an hour.
Mr. Moderator?
I think that we should give him a better range of wage.
Ms. Conkle, you good?
We currently have an individual that's in place, that's been in place for several months, that does have that experience.
Any other comments or questions? Whoop, sorry.
Sorry. I just, bringing in a new accountant and cutting hours doesn't seem to compute. I just can't see a new accountant coming in and doing it for less hours than what the previous accountant was doing. Would the interim accountant care to comment?
Mr. Moderator, if she doesn't mind if I comment for her, without throwing the old accountant under the bus, I truly believe, and our interim accountant's actually working about half the hours, is doing probably a good 50%, to exaggerate 100% better than our old accountant. And that's my personal opinion. If she would like to comment, that's on her.
Mr. Moderator,
yes.
I would like to ask the selectmen, partly to reassure people, whether they did some kind of survey of area towns and how many hours a week their accountants work, because I believe that the reduction in hours is very reasonable for a town this size. And I think that if people could be reassured that this is not out of line with other communities, that would go some way to helping people understand that this kind of change is going to work just fine.
I did that, Trudy, already.
Right. Pull the mic.
Pull the mic. I did the survey, and they were all working about 20 hours a week.
Thank you.
Okay, anyone else? Okay, if not, we're ready to vote on town accountant salary of $35,000. Okay, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no.
No.
That's a vote. Okay. The next one I have is item 240, town accountant audit.
Mr. Moderator, that was my question. I was wondering why the advisory committee does not recommend any money for an audit when we're going to be having a change in accountant, and it seems that it would be a good year to have money for an audit, either for the last books that the retiring town accountant did, or at least for to give a baseline for the new town accountant, so that we know everything is in shape. And maybe there's a reasonable explanation here, but I'd like to hear it.
Mr. Moderator, can I take that?
You certainly may.
Mr. Moderator, we currently have $34,000 in the audit account. That's okay. Because we've allocated other years and it's been encumbered but not spent.
Okay.
So we have adequate for actually basically two audits in a single year.
And that's an account that can just carry over?
Correct.
Okay, great. Thank you.
Any other comments or discussion? All right, unless somebody wants to make a motion to put some money in there, we're just going to leave it at zero and move on. Okay? No, we're moving on. Item 280, advisory committee clerk salary.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm out of place. The person that questioned if they wanted to question first. I'm sorry.
My name is Marlene Burbank, and I'm an assessor. And in addition to the 3% issue that we've been discussing, I also have an issue with the fact that we are transitioning in this department to have the three-member board, which used to work all the time in the office.
No, that's...
I think you're in the wrong article.
I'm on the wrong item. I'll sit down until later.
She fell asleep.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I move to approve line item 280 for the amount of $500.
Second. Okay, motion is made and approved to seconded for $500 for advisory committee clerk salary. Any discussion on that one? No? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. We get another vote. Okay. Item 320, assessor's salary.
Mr. Moderator.
Yes.
My name is Marlene Burbank. And I work for the assessors, or I'm an assessor. And we, I don't know for how long, have had a three-member board that did all the work in the office, and we're transitioning to having a three-member board that meets once or twice a month for a few hours and approves things and will help with the tax setting if that's necessary. Other than that, we have a member, we have an employee, an assistant assessor who will be working in the office. And for the stipend for the board, we asked for $1,000 a person. And the advisory board reduced it to $500 a person. I'm not really clear why they did that, because I did some checking around to see what their other boards are making, and I checked with the Central Mass Assessors Association to see what a reasonable stipend was, and $1,000 is right there. So I would like to increase line 320 to the 3% number, whatever that is in the would be, plus the $1,000. Well, it would be $500 each for a $1,000 total more that we need. Oh, wait a minute.
Before you go too far, I'm going to need an exact number.
Is the 3%?
So.
No, Phil told me leave him out of it.
Okay. Okay. Yes. I'm sorry, I forgot that we, meaning Phil and I, have agreed that we don't really need a raise this year. We'll be working for 6 more months at a flat salary, which would be fine with us. So basically, this number of $17,481 needs to be increased by $1,500, which would be $18,981.
Okay. Motion is made and seconded to increase that number to 18,981. Okay, so that's what we're going to talk about. All right, Mr. Holcraft, did you have a question before?
Yeah, just the three. You took the 3%. We don't give 3% or 1% on stipends. You. Okay. All right. You pull that back. All right.
Mr. Moderator.
Yeah.
Actually, last year we corrected a planning board stipend. Old accountant used to like call it salaries. We like to call it stipends. Pretty much everyone in the town that gets a stipend is a $500 stipend. School committees on both sides, planning board, we receive a selectman $2,000 stipends. We, as a board and a committee, agree that a $500 stipend is in line.
Okay, we're still asking for $1,500 increase, so we each have $1,000, because that's in line with what the other assessors are making in the area. And the other thing is, we have to, even though we're still on the board, even though we're on the board and not in the office every day like we have been, we still need to maintain our education.
I'm having a little trouble here understanding what this line 320 is actually paying for. It seems as though what we're doing is paying the assessors a stipend of some amount of money, and we're paying a salary for the person who does the day-to-day work. No?
All right, who wants to try and
Mr. Moderator?
Give an explanation?
Mr. Moderator?
What these numbers mean?
Mr. Moderator.
Yes, sir.
Line item 345 is a new assessor's wage that reflects that one individual. Line 320 reflects the three individuals that are elected. Through their discussion with the advisory committee, they want to, I believe, work for their salaried wage for half a year and then transition over to that stipend portion, and that's what that number reflects.
What the number reflects is Mr. Contour is pretty much right on the mark, but I just want to clarify a little bit. What it entails is half of a year's salary for two selectmen.
Two assessors.
Excuse me, for two assessors, and then the stipend for the other half of the year for those two assessors, and then a $1,000 stipend for the new assessor who was just elected for the whole year.
Shouldn't it be $250? I mean, if we're basing it on a $500 stipend and you're getting a salary for half of the year, shouldn't we split that stipend in half and go with a $250 stipend? Well, that's what they should do.
Let's see if I can figure out what my question was. Yes. I see that they've explained that they want to do salary for half the year and then transition into this new model of a three-person policy-making, et cetera, board, paper signing board, policy-making board, along with an assistant assessor who does have to be certified and certain trained. It isn't just a clerk to come in and fill out a paperwork. They do, as far as I understand it, have to be trained. But my question is that $31,932, if we're looking at their whole transition thing, going to be half the year for an assistant assessor, meaning we're going to be looking at $62,000 next year? No. Okay. So that's a full year. Okay. So you're going to continue as essentially as a paid board, not just a stipended board, but a salaried board for half the year, along with a half a year of, along with the new person. Okay.
We have to continue to train him in
getting all of it.
Okay, okay. I get the picture now. Thank you.
Move the question.
Second.
We have one speaker here, and then we'll give you a shot at it.
This is why we put in 500 in here, because they're not going to be doing this for a whole year, this board. It's, you know, it's 500, and that's why we're doing this. It's in the transition period here. It's only for half a year. And now they still want $1,000 on top of the 500. So we're trying to keep it at, that's one of the reasons we went at 500.
Move the question.
Okay, motion is made and seconded to move the question. We will end debate on this, and we will proceed to vote on the number 18,981. Okay. All those in favor of ending debate, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed? Oh, that's a clear one. Okay, debate's over. The number that you're going to vote on is 18,981. All those in favor of that number, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed to that number, please say no.
No.
Ooh, that's pretty close. Counters, you can get up and walk around. All those in favor of 18,981, please stand.
Twelve.
All those opposed to the 18,981, would you please stand? Motion is defeated, 38-21.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I move to approve line item 320 for the amount of $17,481.
Second.
Okay, motion is made and seconded for the line item to read now $17,481. Any discussion on this one? Okay. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. That one carries. So line item 320 is $17,481. All right. The next one I have is collector software. Line 420. Who wants to talk about this one? Ah, I'm sorry.
I have a note. We passed line 320, 345
already.
She answered her own question. She said, "That's what we like." Anybody got a? Okay.
Hi, Tom Regan. Just curious, it's the number's a big jump. Could someone give me a little more detail as to why we have a bigger number this year than in the past?
Which number? She has changed her software this year. She has gone to the Vadar software. She was using the one that was the same one through the, it was a CAMA system that was through the assessor's office in the state. So she's using a new system this year.
So primary driver on that was that CAMA is no longer going to be supported fiscally from the state of Massachusetts. They were funding through grant monies, the expansion and enhancement of that software. And so in the process, to have that software really be usable on the tax collector side of the house, especially the tax title modules, et cetera,
the tax collector asked to move to VADAR because CAMA was really choking up and operating incredibly slowly because of the format that we were using CAMA in. Literally, you could walk into the office, she would try to run a report, and you would have to go walk away, get a cup of coffee, start your sandwich, and then come back, and you might have your report. So in order to increase the efficiency in the tax collector's office, we're transitioning her to software that aligns with the treasurer and the accountant, because there's more interchange. It also has to occur between those three offices.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to move to accept line item number 420 for the amount of $6,860.
Okay, motion made and seconded for $6,860. Any other comments or questions? If not, all those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. And we got another one. All right. The next one I have is elections and registration expenses, $8,200. Well, it's no number.
Mr. Moderator?
That's the one that's the question.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to move to approve line item number 510 for the amount of $8,226.
Okay. Anybody remember who had the question on that one? Oh, okay.
I noticed in the warrant that there's an electronic voting article, and my question is this line item related to that?
No.
Then what is this? Okay. Then I don't have a question. Thank you.
I'll make a motion that we accept line 510 at 8226.
We already have that.
We do.
Any other questions or comments on it? Okay. Line item 510, $8,226. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, no. We got it done. Okay. Next one I have is planning board salary.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to move that we accept line item number 590 for the amount of $2,500.
Second. Okay. Somebody remember who had the question on that one?
I probably did.
He did.
Yeah, it's on your sheet.
Okay, well, you have the same number listed, so maybe.
He does.
Is it the stipend?
You want me to withdraw or just motion to accept?
We just
no. We've got a motion for $2,500, and nobody disagrees with it. We'll just
second it.
Okay. If no discussion, all those in favor of planning board salary reading $2,500, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. All right. We got that one. 6:30. Next one I have is 660.
Mr. Moderator.
I'm go ahead.
Sorry. I move to accept line item number 660 for the amount of $14,029.
Second.
Okay. I have no idea who had the question on that one.
I didn't question it.
I did. I did.
Okay.
Linda Purse, why do we have a decrease in the custodian's salary?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
That is the amount that individual can receive for the year.
All right, any other comments or questions? If not, all those in favor of $14,029 for municipal custodian wages, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. We got another one down. Next one I have is town hall improvements.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I move to accept line item 680 at the amount of $15,000.
Okay, motion made and seconded for $15,000.
Hi, Peter Martel. What's the asterisk mean? Okay.
Mr. Moderator.
I don't know if it was referencing something or an article or if it was just a typo.
Mr. Moderator, it is an editing artifact from a number of years ago when that line item was established as a warrant article originally.
All right, any other comments or questions on it? Okay, all those in favor of the figure $15,000 for town hall improvements, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, say no. All right, we've got that one. Okay, the next one I have is police chief salary.
Mike Blanchard, it's incorrect. It should read $68,711. My salary for FY16 was not $67,623, but actually $67,364 was my salary last year. So the 2% raise should be $68,711.
So moved.
We need a town resident to make that motion.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to make a motion to accept line item number 780 for the amount of, and bear with me, please.
68,711.
I'm going to make the motion at $69,385 based on giving everyone else this evening a 3% raise. Our police chief deserves a 3% raise as well. $69,385.
$69,385?
Correct.
Is that right, Steve?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, discussion. All right.
Quick question. Is the chief under contract?
No, he is not.
So you guys don't sign any paper with him with whatsoever?
We do, but we have not.
So you are working on a contract with the chief?
We were in negotiations, and it was just based on a COLA.
Okay, I'm a little lost here, but
you can vote on the number, Herb. It's up to you.
Well, I'm just trying.
Okay, wait. Just, address the moderator, and we'll get there.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
In regards to Mr. Chafee's question, the Board of Selectmen were negotiating a 3-year contract. One had not been reached, but based on this evening, everyone receiving a 3% raise, I feel it's fair, and that's why I'm personally making the motion. It's not through the board. They can vote however they'd like. I'm making the motion for a 3% raise. And as far as I'm concerned, I would not sign a 3-year contract. We would readdress it next year.
Okay, you answered my question.
Second.
Onward.
Any other comments, questions, discussion? Okay. So the figure is $69,385. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, no. Okay, we got a vote there. 790, police wages part-time.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I move to accept line item number 790 for the amount of $54,466.
Okay. Any discussion on...
Why do we have a 12.9% increase? And how many part-time police officers do we have?
Defer to the chief.
The increase is due to the fact that this fiscal year we had 2 eve shifts that were not manned with 2 patrolmen. So this is increasing one of those E shifts to have 2 patrolmen on it. So it's filling another part-time shift on a day that we did not have one on. And then we have 7 part-time officers at this time.
Okay,
Why are we not giving them a 3% raise? They're not bound by a contract either.
Anybody want to try and answer that question?
I'm not going to totally answer it. There was a 3% based on the 48 figure because I didn't know what he was doing, shuffling, adding man hours or whatever. So he can factor 3% in right now.
the 3% was what you had on your sheet, Bruce. It was a $55,595.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to amend my motion for that amount.
All right, motion is amended to read $55,595. Okay, any discussion on that? If not, all those in favor of amending the motion to read $55,595, please say aye. Opposed, no. Okay, the motion is amended. Unless there's some other discussion, I'm moving right to do the same thing again. All those in favor of approving $55,595, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Okay. Next one I have is... Wow, we're moving right along here. Do we?
885,
Chief. Okay.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion to approve line item number 885 for the amount of $3,476. And that's based on a 3% raise from last year.
Okay. Any questions, comments, discussion? Okay. All those in favor of 885, reading $3,476, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no.
No.
People are getting tired, but we're going. Okay, the next one I have is zoning enforcement officer salary.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion to accept line item number 1100 for the amount of $7,070.
Okay, motion made and seconded for zoning enforcement officer salary of $7,070.
Why have we got a decrease in the salary?
Who wants to tackle that one?
The advisory committee.
I'll answer that. Okay. This is a new zoning officer, and he came in at a lower rate than the old one. We based on hours and what needed to be done in town, and like I said, he's just coming on board, so that's why we reduced it.
Okay, any other comments or questions on the $7,070? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right. Next one I have is parking ticket clerk and hearing officer salary.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to make a motion to accept line item 1220 for the amount of $250.
Was there a second? Okay. Any discussion on this one? Hearing none. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. The next one I have is school expenses.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion to approve and accept line item number 1330 for the amount of $2,957,688.
Motion made and seconded. Any discussion on this one? Okay. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. Okay. Okay, the next one I have is Board of Health salary.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to move that we accept line item number 1630 for the amount of $3,600.
Okay, any comments or questions, discussion on this one? If not, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right. The next one I have is Council on Aging Outreach Worker.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion to accept line item number 1760 for the amount of $1,500.
Okay. Any discussion on this one? Okay. All in favor of the $1,500, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right. The next one I have is 1830, Veterans Agent Casework.
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion to approve line item number 1830 for the amount of $55,000.
Okay. Motion made and seconded. Okay, Pat?
I'm just wondering why the number was decreased by 17,000. I know that a couple of years ago we increased it when I was on the advisory board because we had that many veterans in town that needed the services. Do we have less veterans or less veterans that need services in town?
Mr. Moderator?
Yes.
It's my belief that there was a request due to the less, there were less veterans in need of services in the town.
Any other questions, discussion? Okay, veterans agent casework of 55,000. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, no. All right. I think
that's it.
I think that's it. Did I miss something?
Nope.
I'm closing the book.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And I'm opening a new one.